Homo Erectus, the first to ever migrate out of Africa, extending across Asia and Europe, and lived throughout the Pleistocene period from about 1.9 million to 143,000 years ago. By this time, the cranial capacity had increased and they may have been the first kinds to use rafts to cross oceans. The reasons for the extinction of Homo erectus have been the subject of much debate among scientists, and several hypotheses have been proposed. The extinction of Homo erectus was a major event in human evolution. This species was the longest-lived relative of our own species, first evolving in Africa and, according to new dating of fossils from Java, Indonesia, Homo erectus persisted in this region until around 108,000 to 117,000 years ago. For comparison, our own species, Homo sapiens, evolved in Africa only about 300,000 years ago. The new dates from Java confirm that Homo erectus overlapped in time with our species, but went extinct before modern humans arrived in Southeast Asia, where the last population of Homo erectus is thought to have lived. One of the most widely accepted hypotheses for the extinction of Homo erectus is that it was due to competition with other hominid species. During the Middle Pleistocene epoch, several other hominid species such as Homo heidelbergensis emerged and began to compete with Homo erectus for resources. Homo erectus have been outcompeted by these other hominids, which were better adapted to the changing environmental conditions of the time. One other research indicates that Homo erectus likely went extinct due to climate change. Researchers said that Homo erectus was found with a collection of animal fossils that lived in an open woodland environment similar to the environment in Africa where it evolved. The environment at Ngandong changed and the open woodland was replaced by a rainforest. No Homo erectus fossils are found after the environment changed, so they likely were unable to adapt to this new rainforest environment. However, these findings suggest Homo erectus may have overlapped with a different human lineage, the mysterious Denisovans, an extinct group currently known only from fossils unearthed in Siberia and the Tibetan Plateau, but whose genetic influence has been seen as far as New Guinea. Scientists say that the possibility that Denisovans interbred with Homo erectus, potentially explaining some archaic DNA seen in their genes, is an exciting prospect well worth exploring. A third hypothesis for the extinction of Homo erectus is that it was due to a combination of environmental factors and cultural factors. Some scientists have suggested that Homo erectus was not as culturally advanced as some of the other hominids that emerged during the late Pleistocene epoch, and that this may have contributed to its extinction. For example, Homo heidelbergensis and Neanderthals were both known to have developed more sophisticated tools and weapons than Homo erectus, which may have given them an advantage in hunting and gathering. What is most interesting, though, is that a new archaeological research from the Australian National University has found that Homo erectus, an extinct species of primitive humans, went extinct in part because they were lazy. An archaeological excavation of ancient human populations in the Arabian Peninsula during the early Stone Age found that Homo erectus used least effort strategies for tool making and collecting resources. This laziness, paired with an inability to adapt to a changing climate, likely played a role in the species going extinct, according to lead researcher Dr. Suri Shipton of the ANU School of Culture, History and Language. Dr. Shipton said, "They really don't seem to have been pushing themselves, and that this was evident in the way the species made their stone tools and collected resources." He said, To make their stone tools, they would use whatever rocks they could find lying around their camp, which were mostly of comparatively low quality to what later stone tools makers used. At the site they looked at, there was a big rocky outcrop of quality stone just a short distance away up a small hill. But rather than walking up the hill, they would just use whatever bits had rolled down and were lying at the bottom. When the researchers looked at the rocky outcrop, there were no signs of any activity, no artifacts, and no quarrying of the stone. They knew it was there. But because they had enough adequate resources, they seem to have thought, why bother? This is in contrast to the stone tool makers of later periods, including early Homo sapiens and Neanderthals, who were climbing mountains to find good quality stone, cutting it over long distances. Dr. Shipton said, a failure to progress technologically as the environment dried out into a desert also contributed to the population's demise, and that not only were they lazy, but they were also very conservative. The sediment samples showed the environment around them was changing, but they were doing the exact same things with their tools. There was no progression at all, and their tools are never very far from these now dry riverbeds. They think in the end, the environment just got too dry for them. The excavation and survey work were undertaken in 2014 at the site of Safaka near Dawadmi in central Saudi Arabia. One last hypothesis is that the last known members of the Homo erectus species were killed in a mass death event between 117,000 and 108,000 years ago. By reanalyzing remains first discovered almost a century ago, researchers were able to better confine the date they died, potentially providing a clearer insight into when and why our ancient ancestors went extinct. When the species disappeared is unclear, however. In the 1930s, archaeologists uncovered a bone site just above the Solo River at Ngandong, Central Java. It contained 12 skull caps and two lower leg bones belonging to Homo erectus. Kyochon is one of the researchers who have returned to Ngandong to reassess the site and the Homo erectus remains found there. Using a series of dating techniques, the team was able to determine the fossils were between 117,000 and 108,000 years old. This makes them the latest known Homo erectus fossils in the world, published in the journal Nature. Researchers believe the individuals, all adults, were killed in a mass death event upstream and were subsequently washed down the river during a flood and deposited where they were eventually found over 100,000 years later. There are many theories as to what caused the mass death, including a volcanic mudflow. But the carcasses and bones that were lying on the landscape were incorporated into flood waters and deposited downstream at the site of Ngandong, where the river narrows slightly. Because previous dating suggested Homo erectus may have survived on Java until 27,000 years ago, it was thought that the species may have coexisted with modern humans for up to 50,000 years. It was also suggested our arrival may have played a role in their demise. However, the new dates showed this cannot be the case. In the study, the researchers show that at the time of the mass death, the environment in Java was changing substantially, shifting from open woodlands towards rainforests. This may indicate that Homo erectus extinction was related to the changing climate. This region served as a refuge for the remaining population of Homo erectus, researchers said. But by 117,000 to 108,000 years ago, this refugia could no longer be supported by the prevailing climatic and environmental changes, and the Ngandong erectus and its associated fauna disappeared from the fossil record. The researchers say their dates are not necessarily the point at which Homo erectus went extinct, but is the point when the last known individuals died. There may well be fossils from later that have not been found. Regardless of the specific reasons for its extinction, it is clear that Homo erectus was a highly successful species for millions of years. The extinction of Homo erectus was a significant event in the evolution of our species, and it is still the subject of much scientific research and debate. Thanks for watching, guys, and hope you enjoyed the video. Before you go, please don't forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.